before two or three, before 2 years, it was totally black, totally dark. But today you can see the original colors. And I said the ceiling of the Great Hall of Columns, we have columns with the head of Hathor, we call them Hathoric columns. And above the head, as you can see, there is something like a box.
Yeah.
This is her musical box, because she was goddess of dancing and music as well.
Yeah.
And we have seen her symbol today in Abydos. We have seen the sister that was her symbol. As I said, the ceiling has been divided into one, two, three, the middle one, and then three at the other side. Yeah. So we have seven sections, each having variety of the astronomical scenes. And like this one above us here is talking about the different phases of the moon. Of the moon, you see gods in lunar or maybe solar boats, but you see the different phases of them. As I said, that we get a number of different calendars from ancient India. We have two solar ones and a lunar one. And the lunar one is still used until today by the digital farmers. Until today. But the lunar one, the solar one is very accurate, and they reach the 3, 6, 5, 5 something a day a year. But the problem for the ancient Egyptian that the day had 24 hours, he got 12 hours and the man got 12 hours. The problem for them, the days in summer were longer. Days in summer were longer than daytime in summer was longer than night. But important that we have a look at the first section at the right hand side here, where we see a beautiful scene, a unique scene of the goddess Nut. M-U-T, not nut, but moot. You can see her face there at the corner. And you see her arms. And this is her body, where you see the zigzag signs. And ending here by her legs, as you can see. The story that she was the mother of the sun. She was the creator of the sun. You see towards her lap here, above me, you see the sun coming out of her lap. She's given birth to a new sun in the form of a scarab. You see the scarab with the wings? Because the sun got three different forms, and the scarab represented the rising sun. The rising sun. And of course the other form was the solar disk, the midday sun. And the third form of the sun was an old man with a ram head facing west, representing the setting sun. And facing west, yani west for the Egyptian meant death. And also west meant tomorrow. Because we don't die, you will not gain the eternal life once again. You have to die first, you have to go west first, so that you can reborn again next morning. I know I will talk about it. But among all the signs that you see here, and you see the constellations, and they are talking about the stars, but among them you can see at least six different star signs. And I see the Leo above me here. Above me. You see the Leo in one of the barks. And even the barks, they are taking the shape of snakes. You can see. And towards the middle, you can see the Libra. One, two, scale, yani above the second column here. Next to the second column, you see the Libra, and in between there is a solar disk. Mind your steps. Exactly above me now. See the scale, like this, and there is a solar disk in between. See the scale? Do you see it? You don't see it. Do you see the broken part behind the leaf?
I can see.
There is the symbol like a rope and four, six standing figures.
Yes.
They are two twin together.
Yes.
Behind them is the Libra. Is the scale.
Yeah.
scale, and then there is like a solar disk in the middle. Mm-hmm. Type. Three figures, four figures left. The fifth one is the Scorpio.
Oh,
I can see it. Then Sagittarius, you see it above, next to the black box. You see the black block?
Yeah.
Left of the black block, or west of the black block, east of the black block, you see the Sagittarius.
Uh-huh.
I see it, huh?
Yeah.
And also I can see here the Capricorn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is one missing anyway. One missing, I can't see. I think it is the twin here. This one is the twin. Then we have another six star signs at the other side. But.
Can I have 12?
Hmm? 12. Yeah. The day. The month in ancient Egypt got 30 days. Mm. 3 weeks each month, not four. Mm. 10 days each. Mm. This is what I mentioned, they make together 30 by.
Yeah.
So by 10, 360, and the five feast days, the extra. Let's go to the other side.
So I wonder why it got changed. I wonder why it changed. You still have to.
Actually, this division was changed by the Romans.
They say the Gregorian.
Gregorian, exactly. That's what we changed by the Romans.
We are now by the Romans.
Again, you see the representation of the vulture, then we agree. They put the vulture as the cleaner. Again, stressing this, the cleaner.
Yeah.
But from here, you can see that the level of the ground of the temple is getting slightly higher.
Yeah.
As long as we approach the holy of holies at the back, the shrine of the goddess. The shrine, the holy of holies, I don't like to call it holy of holies, I prefer to call it sanctuary. Because they were stopping anyone of entering but the high priest. Actually, originally the sanctuary is representing the original eternal mound that arose from the water when the world was created. And as they believe, of the creation of the world, at the very beginning there was nothing but just darkness and water. From the eternal ocean arose a little mound, symbolizing here the shrine of the god or the goddess here, the sanctuary. And upon this little island that arose from the water, the creator God created himself. His name was Atum, the complete one. Atum from the verb Tim. The stem is Tim. Tim means complete. The best or the perfect view. He's the complete one. How he produced himself by himself? He was hermaphrodite. He masturbated. And then he swallowed this. The semen, and then he became pregnant. And then he generated two children, a boy and a girl. Then the circle started. Boy and a girl, they married, they got another two. They married the two children, the two grandchildren. One of them was Nut, that we have seen her picture there. The sky goddess, Nut, and the god of her, Geb, her husband. And then the last four, they were the four children. Four, Isis, Osiris, Seth, and Nephthys. So I just wanted to say that the shrine or the sanctuary representing, symbolizing the eternal mound that arose from the moon. And you can tell you with the screen walls, you know the front columns, they are joined with screen walls, curtains, like curtains. But we have decorations, we have names of at least four Roman emperors. Four Roman emperors.
Before, so that was before? Roman emperors came after?
After, yeah.
So how can they have the names of...
Because this was built by the Romans.
This was built by the Romans.
Ah.
This is not
This was not built under the ancient Egyptian pharaohs. This was built under the Romans. One of them, he left his name and its complete name, Vespasianus, one of them.
So wouldn't
that
be false?
Crowned in Egypt.
Wouldn't that be false if the Romans built this? It's not Egyptian?
No, this is still Egyptian temple in design,
yeah.
Built by the ancient Egyptian workers, dedicated to the ancient Egyptian gods.
But the architects?
Everything is Egyptian, but was built under foreign pharaohs.
Yeah. Mm.
Like Alexander, he invaded Egypt.
Mm.
Did he build the temple by himself, or he brought workers from Macedonia?
Yeah.
No, just in a political way that they needed to show their respect to the ancient Egyptian gods, to the ancient Egyptian culture, religion, adopting their gods. Well, that was the way.
It was a gesture of.
That was the way.
Yeah. But Alexander declared himself a pharaoh.
Of course,
yeah.
Of course. After he visited the Oracle Temple of Amun on the Western Desert, near the Libyan borders, and that was the first thing that he done. After he arrived to Egypt, he said, "I will find my way to the main temple of Egypt, that was Amun Temple, near Libyan borders." He went there to the temple. He spoke with the priest, asked the permission. Please allow me to get inside the shrine of the god. I want to talk with the god Amun. He got in the little chamber, in the dark chamber. After all, he came out of the chamber telling them, my father, the god Amun, he selected me as the pharaoh of Egypt. So it's that easy. Yeah. Whoever going to respect the Egyptian culture and religion and gods? Any Egyptian president now, yesterday, or tomorrow even, yeah. If you're not going to respect the people and respect the tradition and the culture,
he's not
working. Yes, anyone. We can tell you it's a beautiful scene this time, and a scene, very symbolic one. Beautiful scene of the goddess Nut, again the sky goddess, and a great member of the Knead of Heliopolis. But look at her lab and lips at that side. You see the sun coming out of her lab and shining over the temple of Hathor. The temple of Hathor, you see the face of the goddess?
Uh-huh.
You see the solar disk coming out of her lap?
Yeah.
You see the sun rays?
Yeah.
Huh? Shining, shining over the temple of the goddess Hathor. Hathor, she got so different titles, and so different functions. In the Delta area, she was called the Mistress of the South. In the South here, she was called Lady of the Turquoise, Mistress of Sinai. Because the Sinai was the source for the turquoise in ancient Egypt. So the ancient Egyptian workers that used to mine the gold and turquoise from Sinai, they built shrines for her, since she was their patroness god. You can see the other six signs of the star signs here. And if you can, Taurus is one of them. Come from Giza. I see fish. There is a fish somewhere here.
Yeah, there is.
Taurus is one.
Taurus.
Yeah, this is one. Fish,
Turkish.
Actually, every one of them also represented one of the constellations.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, Sirius for them represented Isis. Sirius represented.
Hello?
No, Sirius represented Osiris, I'm sorry.
Hello. Yes, thank you. Yeah.
Great job was done here in this place.
Yeah.
Really, yeah. The color. It was totally black.
Yeah.
And they left half of the ceiling in the middle right from here to show us
to
the difference.
Yeah. So, who worked on this? Which?
Egyptian team. Egyptian team. Yeah.
Fantastic.
I think they still, but not today. Today's Friday.
So they're still working here. Yeah.
I'm sure they still work at the airport.
Very awesome.
Yeah, let me get inside. Again, this is not soot, by the way. This is risen from the early archaeologists who made copies. Who made copies of wax or whatever and used the resin. They made copies and they
spoiled it, yeah.
Not so. So we enter to the Ptolemaic section. We have the first pole of columns, Roman. Mm-hmm. The courtyard, Roman. The entrance, the gate there, Roman. Mm-hmm. And here we enter to the oldest part of the temple, the Ptolemaic section, the Greek section of the temple. And here we have a small hall of columns, six columns supporting the roof. And I think I have not seen it. Once again in Egypt, we have mixed column between granite and sandstone. And in the base and the first Roman is granite, and then the rest of the shaft, including the floral capital, is a sandstone. And still, the ceiling and the capitals of the columns are black here. I can't say just smoke. Not just smoke, but. But anyway, this still working here, you can see, but not today. We have scenes here relating to the foundation service of the temple, as we have seen in Abydos. But the problem for us here, that names of the pharaohs were not mentioned. And if you look, you will notice that the cartouches, the oval rings where they used to describe the names of the pharaohs, still blackened, still empty. Still empty. So you just see a pharaoh, a nameless pharaoh. The two cartouches in front of him are empty. Where's the crown of Lower Egypt? And then he's breaking the sacred ground in front of the goddess, in front of the goddess Hathor. There's so many details, but as you see, that many of the figures have been defaced. You still can see the chisel marks. Huh? Everything was defaced, as you can see here.
Just think, somebody actually carved this.
These are the chisel marks. Yeah. Someone deliberately spent time and effort destroyed them. Spent time and effort of destroying the figures. But again and again, they destroyed the figures, but they left the names.
Yeah.
So it was again, is the figure as a figure, as human, or as whatever, as animal? So you still can see the chisel mark. The cartouches are empty, no names.
Yeah, no.
Yani, could be the reason for the empty cartouches, as some of the scholars suggested that the priests who were constructing this temple, because that was a time of a civil war in Egypt within the Ptolemaic royal family. That was a time of a civil war, and there was no just one pharaoh for all Egypt. There were different pharaohs. Egypt had been subdivided in several states. So the priests, they constructed the temple and were unsure for whom they were constructing the temple. So they left the names empty. And even they painted the cartouches. They painted the cartouches and they put plaster inside. Plastering will be easy in the future, just to draw the names, not carving them. Carving. Maybe there were names written and have been removed after that. But we have so many side rooms because this temple was full of feasts the whole year. We have one room there leading to a well outside the temple, and the water well and the neighboring area there was used later on in the late Roman period in Egypt as a sanatorium. This temple was one of the healing centers in ancient Egypt. The official name of this temple in ancient Egypt, it was called Beran, House of Life. Ah. What is House of Life? Hospital. House of Life, Beran. That was one of the healing centers together with Kumombo. Komombo also. Mm. And there in Komombo we have the very famous scene of the god of medicine.